Welcome to CYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So friends, what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus of UPSC into 12 subtopics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Art and Culture, Polity, Geography, Economy, Current Affairs, and further other topics also. So we have divided your whole syllabus into 12 subtopics, and what we do, we daily discuss two subtopics, and in this manner, in 6 days, your 12 subtopics of the entire syllabus are covered, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion, friends. So today is this lecture of geography, and this is lecture number 14. The first question is, why floods are a frequent occurrence in Brahmaputra river basin? First, the tributaries of Brahmaputra are large and bring large water and sediment volume. Second, the Brahmaputra often witnesses heavy rainfall in its catchment area. So which of the above is correct? Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. Actually, the tributaries of Brahmaputra are quite large, and they bring large amount of water with them as well as sediment, and also there is a lot of rainfall in the catchment area. Another reason is that basically the Himalayas that are crossed by the Brahmaputra, they are composed of semi-consolidated rock material, so it is very very much vulnerable to erosion. So that's why due to the erosion, the sediment or the silt deposition in the riverbed takes place to a large extent, which causes the water to cross over its natural embankment, natural levees, and this causes floods. So the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So the solution is C. So here is the explanation. As I have already told you, 40% of the Assam's land is flood prone due to this. So there are multiple other reasons also associated with this. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, Brent crude is often used as a benchmark for the prices of other crude oils. It is found in parts of North Sea off the coast of. So friends, here we have been asked that the Brent crude, which is used as a benchmark for the prices of other crude oils, it is found in North Sea off the coast of. So here we have been asked, A is Finland and Sweden, B Biscay near France, C British Isles Island in Ireland, and UK and Norway. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is D, that is UK and Norway. So the Brent blend makes up more than half of the world's globally traded supply of crude oil. So here is a diagram as I have included. So here you can see the Finland, you can see clearly Finland, Sweden, and Norway, and between Norway and UK, that is Britain, is the North Sea where Brent crude oil is found. So you can please observe the maps carefully, because such type of things are often asked by the UPSC. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, consider the following matches of major physical features of Europe with relevant groups. First, Balkan Peninsula stretch from Serbia to Bulgaria. Second, Rhine River region in Swiss Alps. Third, Volga River flows through Central Russia. Fourth, Alps Mountains passes through France and Germany. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is D. That is, all are correctly matched. That was 1, 2, 3 and 4, all are correctly matched. So solution is D. So here is there is nothing to explain about it. It is basically a map work. If you observe them, if you are observing the maps carefully, then you will be able to answer this question. So all these things are mentioned here. So there is nothing to explain. So there are mere facts which you have to learn, and you have to observe the maps carefully. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, the Indian islands of Arabian Sea are, first, spread from equator 0 degree latitude to 15 degree latitude north. Second, largely made of coral deposits. Let me tell you, friends, that the second statement is correct. They are largely made of coral deposits. But let me tell you, first statement is not correct, because actually the latitudinal extent of India begins from 8 degree north. And these Lakshadweep islands, that is the islands in Arabian Sea, they are found between 8 degree and 12 degree north, and also latitudinal extent is 71 degree east to 74 degree east. So the solution is B. So here is the explanation. So the latitudinal extent begins from 8 degree north, And islands of Arabian Sea include Lakshadweep and Minicoy. And Minicoy is the largest island. They are scattered between 8 degree north and 12 degree north, and 71 degree east and 74 degree east longitude. So they are located approximately 280 to 480 kilometers off the Kerala coast. The entire group is composed of coral deposits, and Minicoy is the largest island. Let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, the Union government is planning to fast track several projects in Indus River Basin to increase irrigation area in Jammu and Kashmir. Consider the following matches of these projects from with the region they are related with. First, Prakchik Khos Canal, Kargil. Second, Thral Irrigation Project, Pulwama. Third, Ravi Canal, Sambha. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that all these projects are rightly matched with their regions. So the solution would be D. So here is the explanation. So India is considering to use its entire water of that is Pakistan-controlled rivers Indus, Jhelum, and Chenab as per Indus Water Treaty. It is trying to exploit the maximum the water of Pakistan-controlled rivers. So let's move on to the sixth question. Sixth question is, of the cyclones hitting the coastal regions of the country, on an average 4 out of 5 hit the eastern shores of peninsular India. Why is the east coast and the Bay of Bengal more prone to tropical cyclones than the western coast and the Arabian Sea? A. Breakaway typhoons over the northwest Pacific move across the South China Sea into the Bay of Bengal, intensifying the cyclones. B. Arabian Sea is colder than the Bay of Bengal Sea. Both A and B. D. None of the above. Let me tell you, friends, that you might be knowing about this fact if you have read the NCRTs, that this India's eastern coast is more prone to these tropical cyclones as compared to the western coast. So the main reason behind the Arabian Sea is colder as compared to Bay of Bengal, and the sea surface temperature is quite warm, and this provides ideal conditions for tropical cyclones. And also the typhoons that form over the northwest Pacific Ocean, they cross over the South China Sea to enter into the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal, and thus intensify they get intensified when they reach Bay of Bengal, and thus they hit the eastern coast of India. Whereas in Arabian Sea, the surface is quite cold, and this formation is not that much robust of your tropical cyclones. And now, moreover, they move away from the India's coast towards the northwest direction. So answer would be both A and B, that is C. The solution is C. So here is the explanation. So as I've already provided you in detail explanation, there is no point of wasting time here. Let's move on to the seventh question. Seventh question is, the driving force behind the southwest monsoons in India is, first, difference between the sea land temperature, second, western disturbances. Which of the above is correct? A, one only, B, second only, C, both one and two, D, none. Let me tell you, friends, that only first reason is responsible for this southwest monsoons. Though there are multiple reasons from these given statements, only first is responsible. Actually, the difference in sea and land surface temperature creates the pressure differences. The pressure over the Indian mainland is quite low, and over the sea is quite high. So all winds always move from high pressure to low pressure, and thus this difference leads to the formation of southwest monsoons in India. And the solution is A, that is one only. So this is about your explanation part, and basically this western disturbances are not responsible for this southwest monsoon. In fact, they are responsible for the rainfall in winter season over the northwestern India, for example in the states of Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand. In areas of Uttarakhand and Machal Pradesh and Kashmir areas, we witness snowfall due to this. Let's move on to the eighth question. Eighth question is, as compared to the Himalayan rivers, the peninsular rivers carry little silt. Why is this the case? So friends, it is quite a common observation that peninsular rivers do not carry much silt. So what is the reason behind it? First, peninsular rivers flow at a much slower rate than the Himalayan river. Second, the peninsular block is characterized by hard rocky terrain. Let me tell you, friends, that the speed of the rivers do play an important role in the erosion, and thus consequently the carrying of the silt with itself. But let me tell you that first statement is wrong, because the peninsular river flow is quite fast, they flow at a quite fast rate than the Himalayan rivers. So first is the note the reason, the second is in fact the reason. The peninsular block is characterized by hard rocky terrain, whereas these Himalayan rivers they flow over the Himalayas, which are composed of semi-consolidated rock. So the answer is second only. So the B is the answer. So here is the explanation. The peninsular rivers flow at much faster rate than their Himalayan counterparts, and also the peninsular blocks are hard, rocky, old, and consolidated. Little silt is accumulated by these rivers. Now let's move on to the last question of the day, that is the ninth question. The correct order of these Himalayan ranges from north to south is: first Pir Panjal, second Jaskar, third Karakoram, fourth Shivalik. Let me tell you, friends, that the Karakoram is in the is the north is to the northernmost, and the Shivalik is to the southernmost. So in between lies the Karakoram. This is Jaskar, Pir Panjal, and Shivalik. So this would be the order: Karakoram, Jaskar, Pir Panjal, and Shivalik. So in fact this is the A option is this 3, 2, 1, 4. So the answer would be A. So here is the Pir Panjal is the largest range of the lower Himalaya. So you can see here in the diagram. So this is Karakoram range. You can see here this is your Karakoram range, and this is your Hindu Kush range, and this is in Pakistan, and after that comes your Ladakh range, and then comes your Jaskar range, and then comes your this Great Himalayan range, and then comes your Pir Panjal, and then this Dholadhar range, and then this is your Shivalik hills. So this is, you can see, please remember it, these are very important things. Such type of questions are often asked by UPSC to arrange the things in north to south order, or from east to west order, or west to east, for that matter south to north. So please have a look at the maps, so that you can prepare your you can be confident in your exam hall when you will be attempting your exam. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then please ensure that you do hit a like to it, and please ensure that you share it with your friends, and also you subscribe to our channel. Also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications that we do on our or notifications of the updates that we do on our channel. So friends, this is all about today's video, and if in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So this is our official number that is linked with our channel, that is achieveies. So you can contact us at this number, or for that matter this email ID, for the PDF subscription. So friends, why these PDFs are important? Because at the end of the day, you will not be able to revise through 20 to 30 minute long videos, or for that matter you will not be able to revise your syllabus by reading NCERTs, or for that matter standard books, because at that time it will be an utter wastage of time. You will have to do multiple things at that time. So in case you want to ensure that you do the revision in a proper manner and multiple times, these PDFs will you can subscribe to these PDFs. So certainly there is a minimum cost which we will charge for this purpose, but it is kept as minimum as possible for your affordability purpose, as well as for the purpose of our motivation, because we also have to sustain ourselves and stay motivated to help you people. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day. Thank you very